Hello, everyone, and welcome to Directwest 6th Learning Series event, Social Media Usage in Saskatchewan. So we're going to start out with our agenda today. So I'll go through some speaker biographies and introductions. My name is Danny Larn. I'm the Marketing Manager of Brand here at Directwest. On the agenda today, we'll introduce you to our speakers, and then we'll have Al begin with a presentation on some information that we've received through a survey that we run with our customers. We'll then jump to Meow and Julie, who will be focused on the social media usage in Saskatchewan report for some great information about consumers in our province. We'll wrap it up with some Q&A. You can ask anything in our chat at any time throughout the presentation by submitting a question at the top of your screen, and then we'll wrap it up with some closing remarks. So your speakers for today. So your first speaker will be Alan Milham. Al's in his 34th year at Directwest and currently operates as our research manager. For many of those years, his role has been to monitor business and consumer trends and determine how they will impact Directwest and our customers. When away from work, Alan serves as past chair of the Better Business Bureau of Saskatchewan and enjoys traveling, lake time, and learning about history. Our next presenter will be Meow Yu. At Citrix, Meow works closely and collaborates with other senior members of the Research Services Department, assisting at all stages of the research process, from scoping through analysis and reporting. She has a background in both marketing with her Master's of Science and agriculture with her Bachelor's of Science, both from the University of Saskatchewan, and also has experience in both quantitative and qualitative research. Meow has been living in Saskatoon for 10 years and is a big fan of the local makers markets. So our other presenter will be Julie Ellis, also at Citrix. Julie is a research manager there, and she works on full service research projects from initial project conception and research design to analysis and reporting. Having experience in both quantitative and qualitative research, Julie specializes in questionnaire design, data analysis and interpretation, environmental scans, consultation studies, needs assessments, program evaluations, stakeholder communications, and presentation of research findings. Originally from Winnipeg, Julie now lives in Saskatoon with her husband and two young children. So I'll pass this off. I will not pass this off to Al yet. I'll give you a little bit of background on Directwest. So as you all know, Directwest, we've been serving Saskatchewan small businesses for over 100 years. Once just the producers of the SaskTel phone book, we've really transformed into becoming a digital marketing services company. From a product and service standpoint, we went from only offering print products and services to then adding online services that included MySas401 listings and customer supplied photos and videos. Today, we do still offer the traditional print products and services, but we've really evolved our MySas401 listings to become content rich, indexable listings. We also offer professional photo and video packages, as well as digital marketing services such as our digital billboards, search marketing, social media management dashboards, review management dashboards, and then we've recently launched a new local deals product that we have for consumers on MySas401 as well. So now I'll pass it on to Al to start his presentation.
Thank you, Danny. I have the good fortune of being able to get direct feedback from local Saskatchewan businesses. I wanted to share a couple of key points to show just how complex the Saskatchewan advertising space has become. Our customers are telling us that they're using an average of 4.5 different advertising methods right now. Almost half are using Facebook, a third are using Google Ads, and 22% are using billboards, which is why we've moved into providing advertising in those spaces. And to add to this mix, there's also some less frequently used advertising spaces like LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram, sponsorship, websites, and more. It's become a really fragmented media world, but today we have some experts to help us understand how consumers are dealing with this fragmentation. We also asked our customers what their biggest challenges are. Right now, the two biggest are shortages of staff and shortages of inventory. I should mention that we've had some success as a company using social media to find the right job candidates for some of our customers, and that's an option that you may want to consider. Businesses are also using social media to quickly highlight that they have hard to find inventory when it does come into stock. Of course, businesses are also trying to figure out how to use all of these tools at their disposal. So I'd like to let Citrix tell us a little bit about how consumers are using these tools.
For sure. Thanks so much. It's a pleasure to be here, everyone. My name is Julie Ellis. I'm a research manager with Incitrix Research. I'm going to start us off with some introduction to our company, some of the research that we've done, and then I'll turn it over to my colleague Miao to cover some of the key findings from our social media usage report. So just a few things about our organization here. Incitrix is a full service market research firm. It was started way back in 2001, based right here in Saskatoon. Currently, we've grown to over 30 office staff and about 50 call center staff that we now have working completely remotely. We work with a number of Saskatchewan-based businesses and clients, as well as others throughout Canada. We carry our ISO certification to ensure our clients that we handle data and online protocols securely, and we're very much a technology-driven firm. I wanted to just take a few minutes to chat about our online research panel called Saskwatch Research. It's currently home to over 19,000 Saskatchewan residents. And we use that panel to conduct online research for a number of our clients. The panel is the largest proprietary panel in Saskatchewan since about 2008. Residents 18 and up can join and have their opportunity to say, to give their say and their opinions on a variety of issues in the province, as well as within their local communities. The panel is really healthy in our two major centers in the province, Saskatoon and Regina. We also have excellent representation in rural areas, both in the north and south of the province. We have nice representation from minority groups, including our Indigenous populations. And we also have a number of small and medium business owners on our panel with lots of access to both public, private, and nonprofit organizations, and a number of industry and sectors are represented. So the research that we're going to talk to you a little bit about today is our social media usage report. The data was collected during the summer of 2022, and we surveyed a total of 1,200 Saskatchewan residents aged 14 and older for this survey. And then we weighted data to match census representation of the province. Key questions that we asked: what are consumer media usage habits? What social media sources are Saskatchewan consumers using, and how often? How often do consumers notice advertising on social media platforms, and how do they interact with these ads? And how important is it for local businesses to have that online presence? And what are their customers' expectations? So now I'm going to turn it over to my colleague Miao to chat through some of our key findings from the report.
Thanks so much, Julie, for the introduction for the methodology and key questions. And next, I'm going to touch a little bit more on the key findings of this report. And to start, I want to actually add one more thing about our panel and a little bit about how we reached our Generation Z. And knowingly, this group in 2023 are between the age of 10 and 26. And to reach folks below the age of 18, we actually reached our panelists who might have people under the age of 18, and see if they are okay passing over the survey to get their opinions recorded. And we're very fortunate to have a healthy representation of Gen Zs in this report as well, and I'll be talking a little bit further on that part later in this presentation. And this presentation will not cover the entire report, obviously, given the limited time, but hopefully this will offer some insights to your businesses and social media marketing going forward. And on the left, we have some of the data on smartphone usage. Although this question has not been asked in 2022 survey, but it's because the number has been staggered a little bit from previous trending results, but it's clear to see that the vast majority of Saskatchewan residents report that they're planning to use about the same amount of time on their smartphone, if not more. But to note that there has been influence of the pandemic in 2021, but we don't see a trend of slowing down. And if we look around and observe how our colleagues, families, and friends have been using smartphones and how we interact and with other digital platforms and devices, we know that this trend is not slowing down. And think of the last time you actually go back. Think of the last time that we hear the ping from your social media message alerts to it's somebody's birthday today and let's help them celebrate. And your friend or colleague has not been updating their story maybe since last September. And we know that these social media platforms and companies like spend tons of efforts with teams and teams of staff contributing to with a goal to maximize user rates, to get more users and to maximize how much time people spend on their social media platform. And our trended data might be of a milestone and trophy for these companies, because since 2015, when we first started tracking what's the portion of residents who use at least one social media platform in Saskatchewan, from 83% now to 2022, this number has reached 98%. So it is fair to say that almost all Saskatchewan residents are on at least one social media platform. But clearly not all platforms are as popular as others, which we'll be diving a little bit further in our next slide. With the common ground where we understand that to some degree that we have a good chance of reach people to interact with people on social media and perhaps even engage and connect, make connections with them. And our research dives a little bit further down by answering questions such as which platforms has the most users and are more frequently accessed and has the highest ad conversion rate. To cut it short, the answer is Facebook. At least our data tells us this way. Facebook has been seen as kind of an old platform. It's diminishing and is not as popular brought up in our daily conversations as other platforms such as TikTok, Instagram. But from our key attributes that we track in our studies, such as daily user rate, ad clicking or ad conversion rate, to the top picked, top rated platforms in which people would be interested and are most familiar to interact with local businesses, Facebook is still on the top and far leading compared to other platforms that we tracked. In this chart, we only showed four platforms. We would highly recommend you check out our reports on our website, which details the user habits, residents' user habits for all the channels indicated below. And further on Facebook, it has other key characteristics, and like the common stereotype for Facebook, it's not entirely wrong. The user base do skew a little bit older. And Gen Z, Facebook is for sure not the top pick compared to other platforms. And on this chart is one other thing interesting to note is that, as you can see, the TikTok usage from 2020, now at 22, we're seeing a clear increasing trend. Now it's almost reaching a Twitter-sized, if not outcompetes Twitter in terms of user base to some degree. And we are foreseeing a trend to keep growing, and we'll be tracking and measuring this data in our upcoming study as well. Another interesting point about another key finding of our study is that user preference of platform do differ between generations. For taking these four channels as an example, Facebook, you're probably gonna get tired of hearing Facebook after this presentation, but our data does indicate that Facebook shows a stable trend that it's preferred among almost all generations, even though Gen Zs might not prefer it as their number one choice. But it does show a stable trend that it's like far leading compared to other platforms. Moving on to some ad clicking habits, in general, about 3/4 of our Saskatchewan residents do report that they have intentionally clicked on one ad at some point in the past. And 1 in 5 done so within the last week. Not surprisingly, what products are consumers interested at that point, and what products or services are they interested in? And in terms of the value, the quality of the ads, is it attractive or not? It are the top two reasons why people have clicked on that ad. About 1 in 10 done so because they've offered a good deal that are attractive enough. And Directwest does offer one product. Maybe Alan or Daniel, later you can talk more about this local deal, but that might be of interest to you. Lastly, I want to briefly touch on Saskatchewan residents' preference and expectations of local businesses in terms of whether or not having online options and social media presence. Like things would include this data. In this data will be, for example, online booking options available, online shopping options, and whether they have online communication capacities to interact and to get to access information. In general, the result is kind of mixed, with about 50% thinking, oh, it's really important to have these options available. But more interestingly is that our Generation Z and millennials are more keener, more interested in and find it more important to have these options available, given that they're the future consumers with more buying powers upcoming. It will be important for local businesses and smaller businesses to pay more attention in this area. To summarize, there is a clear trend that we have a continuously growth pattern in social media usage in Saskatchewan. And this number has not hit the peak yet. It remains a vital resource and platform, vital resource for local businesses and companies to reach and engage with Saskatchewan consumers. And if one thing as a takeaway, Facebook is not over the hill. It might seem like an old news, but really it still provides outstanding performances in almost all attributes we tested in this study. In addition to the high user rates and ad conversion rates, I still want to emphasize that to connect with local consumers, between local businesses and consumers, Facebook still triumphs as the number one channel on which consumers would like to be contacted and connected. Lastly, thank you all for listening, and further detailed breakdowns of the results are needed, please head over to our website and check out our latest report.
Thank you so much. So we did have some questions come through in the back end. So I'll just start asking some of those. So this one is for Meow and Julie. I'm not sure if you have the number off on hand, but what would the average sample size typically be for Insightrix's surveys?
I can speak to that. The sample size really depends on the type of study we're doing and who we're surveying. If we approach sort of a province-wide survey, we would usually recommend a sample size of 800. And that allows us to cover the province demographics that represents census data fairly quickly, and it gives us enough to do breakdowns by various demographic variables, so age, gender, region of the province, and things like that. For a smaller study, perhaps focused on one of the two urban centers, we might go down to a sample size of 400. And that gives us enough to work with to look at sort of a smaller targeted geographical area. But it really depends on the purpose of the study and how many breakdowns we want to do.
Perfect. That makes sense. The next question we had come through was about the difference in or how Saskatchewan compares to other provinces. Do you guys see any differences from other provinces in terms of their social media use when comparing them to Saskatchewan?
I can perhaps speak to that. Thanks for this question. And we have tracked provincial differences between the province, Prairie provinces, Alberta, Saskatchewan, and Manitoba in the past. We really have not seen much like super huge differences, that hence we stopped tracked these between provinces. Instead, we focused more primarily on Saskatchewan to learn more about the local market.
Sounds good. This one is a little bit more geared towards specific industries. So does Insightrix do any research on how preferred social media platforms vary depending on the industry one works in? So an example could be those who work in agriculture specifically tend to prefer Twitter over Facebook.
So for this question, we don't have a specific question included in this report specifically, but it sounds like a very interesting one to add in the 2023 study. And really research dependent, usually we would add in type of a preference of communication in our, depends on the study, we would add that in. For example, if your company is interested in for specific campaign or specific strategy going forward, we would include a communication preference specifically for social media in the study. And unfortunately, we don't have that specific data available so far.
Okay, thanks. Another question that came through was a question about Instagram. So somebody was a little surprised not to see Instagram really highlighted in the presentation, especially because Pinterest was highlighted, but it seems quite a bit less relevant these days.
Yeah, I think if you go ahead and check out our full report, we have the full data set available for all of the platforms, Instagram, TikTok included.
And how much is the report?
The report is available for $500 from our website. If you head over to insightrix.com, downloads, all of our syndicated research reports are available to preview and purchase there.
Perfect. And we just had one last question. This one's focused on TikTok. So do you see platforms like TikTok attracting an older demographic similar to how Facebook has transitioned over time?
That's a super interesting question. I can maybe jump on that and speak to that a little bit. So I think I can tackle this question from two angles. I think From my understanding, how Facebook has attracted an older demographic right now, it's one, I think, lack of competition when it first started. And two, that the loyal base back then is growing and sticking with Facebook? And do I see TikTok following the same pattern? Personally, I think it really depends on whether the market is like how competitive as the folks as we move along, and at least right now from our data for 2022, it does not seem to be the case. The preference is mainly from younger generation, Gen Z, millennials, compared to boomers and interwar, we are seeing quite minimal usage with that demographic. Hopefully this helps.
Yeah, definitely. I think Facebook, for instance, obviously attracts that older generation, I think primarily because of the connection abilities for them and the ability for that older generation to connect with family members or friends from their past too, which TikTok doesn't really give the opportunity for right now. So that's it for the questions that we had today. So I just want to thank everybody for joining us. We will be emailing out a link to the recording of today's webinar. That'll be posted on Directwest's YouTube channel. And if you'd like to learn any more about Directwest products, please just reach out to your media advisor. And if you have additional questions or would like to purchase the report, feel free to contact Meow or Julie. And have a great day, everybody.